Hi Virgos, welcome to your reading for the month of October 2018. This is going to be a 10 card Celtic cross for Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, welcome back to the channel. I know I was a bit away from the channel for past 2 months for certain reasons. I hope you are doing well. My name is Ayushi, if some of you do not know that. My name is Ayushi, and if you are new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Guys, let's see what are the messages coming in for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising. So some of you are trying to decide which path to take, and how to take that path. Like, you know, you're trying to understand, if I take this path, how to go about, like, planning about this path. So like a magician, you feel that you have all the resources, but how do you put to use these resources is what you're wondering. How to make myself or my resources work in my favor so that I can reap the benefits of my resources is what you're thinking. Or you could be dealing with an Aries person and you're tired dealing with that person because you feel that person is a trickster. And you have also invested a lot in something and it has been finally coming to an end now. Something is coming to an end which was exhausting. Physically exhausting. Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising for the month of October 2018. What are the messages coming in for Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising? 2018, Virgo, Sun, Moon and Rising. 2018, what are the messages coming in for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising? 10 card Celtic cross. Messages for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising. Guys, take the messages that resonate with you and leave the rest, because this is a general reading, so everything is not going to resonate with you. Also, use your intuition. Whatever messages I am giving, it will fit into your situation, because if you will apply your own intuition, these messages, of course, not tailored made or something to suit your personal situation. It's for general people, like, you know, it's a general reading, so just apply it to your situation according to your own intuition. So something at work, definitely something at work, because it's Virgo, it has to be work. And something related to separation, something related to work or three party, or something related to separation, clash of egos. Three of Pentacles can also be about deciding whom to work with, whom to invest with, whom to collaborate with, whom to contact, and the reason for all that is this person right for me to invest in or start something with, so that I can achieve certain goals, certain desires. So yes, Five of Pentacles as a crossing card. So Five of Pentacles is basically somebody being left out in the cold, somebody feeling alone, somebody financially not feeling so well, not doing so well, and that is making them depressed, and it's making their back, like, you know, it's making their back backbone break, basically. That's what I'm getting here. It's also making somebody's youth, like, this person can be young, but they are not feeling as youthful as they should. Now, this could be, you could be dealing with a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius. I'm also getting Aquarius, Leo, Sagittarius. I'm also getting Libra and Aries. So it can be Sun, Moon, Rising. So you can be dealing with someone who is very much set in their own ways, very bossy, very arrogant. This can be your boss, somebody trying to protect something. This can be somebody who is charismatic, somebody who is in the limelight, somebody who gets to take all the decisions, someone who is trying to be center of the attention. People have their people try to like this person gets other people's attention, and they are very attentive, and they take responsibility and leadership roles. Either this can be you who is planning to be all these things in future, or you want to be this person, or you are dealing with somebody who is like this and you are feeling inspired by this person or this figure, or this can be just one of your friends. In past, I'm seeing that you had a soulmate connection with somebody, like it went deeper than it is beyond this life. It was a karmic cycle that you were dealing with in past, so it's very hard to break this cycle. It is beyond emotion, physicality, and you know, material realm. It's something that you cannot understand. It's a sudden and instant deep attraction or connection that you feel towards someone. This is Six of Cups, so it can also mean that somebody in past, in your past, came back from your childhood, who was probably some like your friend or girlfriend or something like that. Currently on your mind, you're very, very confused. You don't know which path to take, which way to go, what is right, what is wrong, which side is up, which side is down. So yes, you are, you have a lot of option. Also, that means that with regards to work or relationship, you have a lot of options. You can choose whatever you want. There is no limit to what you you know, what you can get. So you are fantasizing, some of you. In future, you have Wheel of Fortune, so in future things will again happen the way you know they are already destined. So there is no use trying to worry about the future, what is going to be there in future, how it's going to play out. If you're worrying about all those things, then don't, because future is not going to be controlled by you or what you do right now. You can only do your best and leave the rest. That is the message that I'm getting here. And you cannot rush anything in future. You cannot see what's there. And like, you can only, you know, trust your inner instincts and your knowledge. And from your past, you can see how things have turned out. And that is how you can make sense of future, how it can actually be. So in your past, you must have seen that there was some up and down, and life is not stagnant. So in future also, things will be up and down. So you should be ready, mentally prepared for that. Also in future, it can mean that if things were not working out in your favor, in future things will start working out in your favor, because like I said, things keep on changing. So if you were having a bad time, good things are going to come your way. Now, Four of Swords coming up. So you, right now you are trying to heal yourself, Virgos. You are very much focused in your enlightenment, in your in gaining knowledge, in mastering something. You are trying to heal your traumas or inner conflict. You want to be in, like, you want to stay in a peaceful surrounding. You want to keep your mind very clear and calm. In your surrounding, there is a person who can be a Pisces person. This person is on a hangman mode. Basically, they are not taking any action. They are in an enlightenment mode. They are trying to look at a situation from a various perspective, from a bigger perspective. They won't take any action because it's a hangman. So this is also a major arcana, so it's a very heavy energy. It is not something that they are doing. It is something that is being, that is happening to them. Okay, so yes, so this person is probably out there somewhere, you know, alone, and doing their own thing. So it can be you as well. You are trying to look at a situation from a bigger perspective, and you are also trying to heal yourself. It's a very solitary and a it's a very solitary situation. Meanwhile, somebody is also looking at you, and they are trying to push you to do something, is what I'm getting here. Your fear and your expectation is you want something like an opportunity where you will make a lot of money, or you want to build a company or you want to start a project, and this will require a tremendous amount of effort and commitment for a very, very long time. You cannot just start something and leave it. It is a starting like Ace of Pentacles, so you're waiting for a opportunity to come your way so that you can start building something. And probably you're ready to build something and you're just waiting for the right thing to come your way. You are victorious by the end of this month. You are feeling liberated, you are feeling fresh, you are feeling recognized, you feel that people are appreciating you. You don't feel bogged down, you don't feel chained. You feel that people are noticing your worth and they are recognizing your effort and your true potential and power. Because you have started something new, something passionate, like a new project, or you are feeling something passionate regarding a victory. You are victorious about something, like either you have a idea that you can sell, so you are feeling victorious, or you want your idea to be recognized by people. Yes, you are forgiving and forgetting something related to a Scorpio probably, and you are rising above something that was holding you back, which was chaining you. So you are trying to forget something and forgive something. There is somebody in your surrounding that you are dealing with, probably a Pisces or a Scorpio or a Earth sign. This person, whoever this person is, in isolation, this person is going through a lot of transformation and change in their own life, like a death and a rebirth process, and they can get a little bit stubborn and they can get a little bit narrow-minded. They want to focus on something that they want to focus on. This can be you as well. So I have 4 of Swords clarified by 7 of Swords and the 6 of Swords. So 7 of Swords and 6 of Swords. You are waiting for some information, or you are holding back some information. At the same time, you are deciding that you will move away from something slowly. You are hiding some information, or somebody is hiding some information probably from you, and you are leaving that situation behind. You are going to heal yourself, is what I'm getting. In future, I'm getting that you want to get equal, give and take. You want to have an equal give and take in future. You are waiting for your true love. You are not sure which one is your true love. So you are waiting for a true inspiration and true love. It can be with a water sign, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. So you are trying to defend yourself or your true love from a lot of people. You are trying to stand your ground and be in your dignity and be there for yourself, and you're trying to protect your true love. This love can be at workplace, or there is a choice at workplace. So you could also be dealing with a Gemini person. So somebody has to make a choice between two people at work, and probably you will or somebody will leave a situation with a heavy heart where they had invested a lot of emotions, but they want something concrete, like a mutual relationship or mutual attraction, so they might leave a situation. In past, whoever was your soulmate, you had a lot of anxiety with respect to this person. You had sleepless night with respect to this person and union. You were feeling trapped and broken, and you were feeling that you had no escape from the situation, and your thoughts were really troubling you. Somebody attractive and nurturing has you are probably in touch with somebody who is attractive and nurturing, and you are communicating back and forth. There is a lot of flirting. And I'm also getting that probably you feel that there is something tricky going on, and that's why you might have control issues, and you might have trouble trusting something. So that those are your messages. But by the end of this month, you are feeling very, very victorious, and you are going to forgive and forget the situation, like I said. And in future, you are investing as much as you are getting in return. you're not investing more than you are getting in return. I'm also getting that you are starting something fresh, like an idea or something like that, and you're investing in it, you are getting committed to it. So yes, that was your reading, Virgo. I hope you resonated. If you did, kindly do drop me a comment so that I know that my videos that I make are helpful. So it will encourage me. So let me know, and I'll see you again.